commission, His Excellency the Aga Khan, laying a stone for the people of India in the Garden of Good Neighbor. And what more fitting for so famous a son of India than to pause for refreshment at the Empire Tea Pavilion? For this is extra special. The pot is ancient Tibetan, and the tea the most expensive in the world, worth £30 a pound. So put that in your cup and drink it. And the Aga Khan? Well, the Aga does. And His Excellency Lee, well pleased with his visit to the Empire on parade.
Another Indian sportsman, as well known as Ranji, is celebrating his golden jubilee in this year of Indian jubilees. His Highness the Aga Khan is more priest than prince, since he's head not of an Indian state, but of a division of the followers of Islam or Mohammedanism. On his jubilee, accompanied by the Begum in a saree, he is feted by his spiritual followers at a durbar. The big event was his weighing in gold. He tipped the scales at 17 stones, some 25,000 pounds. The gold was donated to charity and education, which proves that His Highness has indeed a heart of gold.
Members of the Ismaili Khoja community stroll into the gardens of the palace. Mr. Fasilboy shows the Begum a diagram of the scales in which His Highness the Aga Khan will be... The ceremony will attract worldwide attention, and His Highness had a look at samples of the diamonds which will be used. The full value of these precious stones will be distributed by the Aga Khan to the various Ismaili Khoja community.
In Karachi, many of the city's leading citizens come to honor the Aga Khan at the ceremony to mark his 70 years as spiritual leader of the Ismaili Muslim sect. Ali Khan, his eldest son, is greeted on his arrival. With the kingdom by his side, the Aga Khan is driven into the great stadium which bears his name, and where nearly 50,000 people have gathered to welcome him. Many overseas guests are present, and the Begum has a special word with some of them. The Aga Khan, who wears the traditional black cap, is in his 77th year. The climax of the ceremony in his honor takes place on a red and gold stage. Here he is to be weighed against platinum on scales specially made for the occasion. But first, the circular platform upon which he sits is revolved so that his followers may see him. Although His Highness weighs 215 pounds, only a few ounces of platinum are needed, for the scale tips 14 pounds to every ounce used. This ceremony derives from a fund called the Platinum Jubilee Association, which was set up 4 years ago with a target of £3 million. This money, at the Aga Khan's instruction, will be used for the betterment of the Ismaili community in Pakistan. And by 1960, it is hoped, every Ismaili will have a profession or a business of his own. Already, £260,000 has been collected.
News as guests pour in for the wedding of a Muslim prince and a Hollywood actress. The Aga Khan and the Begum, having approved the match, arrive at the town hall, where Miss Margarita Carmen Cancino, rather better known as Rita Hayworth, is to be made one with the dashing young Prince Ali Khan. Rita is wearing a gown of ice blue crepe, with matching tulle-trimmed hat. The prince, that look all bridegrooms wear. The ceremony, conducted by the communist mayor of Bellary, is short and simple.
Pakistan's new delegate, Prince Ali Khan. A familiar figure in world capitals, Prince Ali is the father of the reigning Aga Khan. As the new Pakistani ambassador to the UN, he presents his credentials to Secretary General Doug Hammarskjöld. Prince Ali's salary, 1 rupee a year, approximately 21 cents.
Aga Khan accompanied by the Begum. Our cameraman is one of the few lucky enough to be inside.
Hundreds of others wait for hours in the pouring rain. And when Grace and the Prince do arrive...
At Aswan in Egypt, Prince Karim, the new Aga Khan, arrives with a begum for the funeral of his grandfather. Between the Nile and the desert is the family villa, where the late Aga's body will rest until a permanent mausoleum is finished. Also with Karim are his father Ali Khan and his uncle Sadruddin. According to Muslim custom, the mourners remove their shoes before entering for the funeral rites. The 45-minute service is a comparatively small one, but the thoughts of 20 million Ismaili Muslims are with the family as the spiritual leader of this worldwide community is laid to rest. Clothed in white, the Begum Aga Khan sits by her husband's coffin. The French-born Begum, for so many years the gracious consort of a wise and much-loved leader, is deeply distressed. But in the years to come, she will be a valued counselor to his successor. To the last, the Aga proved his freshness of mind by choosing to succeed him a 20-year-old undergraduate reared in the epoch whose problems he must face.
At a villa outside Geneva, Switzerland, celebration dispels mourning for the late Aga Khan. The fabled Aga, dead at 79, designated in his will that youth succeed him. Prince Karim, followed by his father Ali Khan, is his grandfather's choice as spiritual leader of 20 million Ismaili Muslims. The new Aga Khan is greeted by his uncle, Ali's younger brother, Prince Sadruddin. Year-old Aga Khan IV proclaims the start of his reign. In his predecessor's words, the Ismaili sect needs a modern-minded young leader to cope with the problems of an atomic world.
Collange near Geneva, the Aga Khan's family gather. Ali Khan's fiancée, Bettina, in a dress of opal silk, is early on the scene. The occasion, the wedding of Sadruddin, Ali Khan's brother, who arrives with his mother, Princess Andre. Behind the bridegroom is the 20-year-old Aga Khan, Prince Karim, with his father Ali Khan and his brother Amin, the youngest man of the family. And now at last the bride,
Nina Dyer, Kensington-born model. She's 10 minutes late, which only adds to the photographer's impatience. But there's a bodyguard to take care of such things. Twenty-four-year-old Sadruddin, Sadri for short, is one of the world's richest men. At the moment, he is the only married man in this fabulous family. And the young Aga Khan himself strongly denies rumors that he's even thinking of getting engaged. Sadri and Nina, in the pale grey organdy dress Dior designed for her, leave for the Muslim wedding and the reception at Chateau Bellerive, the family mansion on the shores of Lake Geneva. The name Sadruddin means chief of the faith. Now Nina has a Muslim name too, Shirin, which means sweetness.
With some business associates, the young Aga Khan spent a few crowded days in Sardinia. They looked over the beautiful Emerald Coast and decided to go ahead with a development program. Karim was in a light-hearted mood. He became Aga Khan on the death of his famous grandfather 5 years ago. Land values in Sardinia have rocketed in the last year or two. The tourist experts believe the island will soon be one of the biggest holiday attractions in the Mediterranean. So businessmen wishing to cash in on the glowing prospect know they'll have to act quickly. The Aga Khan and his partners chose sites along Fox Bay. Building will start soon.
The Villa Barakat at Versoix, near Geneva, where the late Aga Khan died, has naturally been the scene of much activity ever since. His younger son, Prince Sadruddin, seen with his fiancée, the former model Nina Dyer, was present for family consultations, and so, of course, was Prince Ali Khan. His son, Prince Karim, who by his grandfather's will succeeds to the title as Aga Khan IV, is seen talking to the press. He is now the imam or spiritual leader of millions of Ismaili Muslims all over the world. He's 20 years old and will have the support and counsel of the Begum Aga Khan and of his father.